Hi, I'm Aaron, the owner of Brisbane Yamaha, and today, yellowfin. What I thought we'd look at was the centre consoles. And it's not a rear centre console, 6.5 metre yellowfin centre console. We sold this boat, it's not a new boat. We sold this boat 6 months ago to a customer, and I can tell you, he's taken it all over the place, he's taken up the cans, he's gone all over the place, and he loves the thing. And he come down for a service and he said, why don't you do a YouTube? Show me boat, I love it. So let's have a look at it, because who's seen one? Well, we have. Good trailer, breakaway, 6.5 metre. Have a look here what he's done over here, Dan, because he does beach launch. He's put this on himself. Don't ask me to do it, because I'm not, right? But have a look at this construction. This guy's half a mechanical genius. Look at that with the bend, so it comes round. Can you see that, Dan? You know, you go down on the beach and that'll extend it, save you. And this is good work. I wonder where you get this from. I'll have to ask him. That bolts into there. You looking at this, Dan? That bolts onto there. Wonderful. Wonderful idea. I love it. I really do, you know. I think this is just a great idea. You know, breakaway trailer, because a boat this size is over 2 tonne. You know, Elco, spare wheel, catch and release. Put them in coat, a big 80 pound on that. 6 mil hull. Look down the hull. Show that, Dan, because they love to look at that shape, because it's the shape that makes these things ride so well. They're just that sharp entry, variable dead rise going back to give you some stability. The floor's up there. Wonderful. Wonderful. Big anchor well. You can put an anchor winch in them. They're made for anchor winches. Come back here and have a look. You know, I'm looking here, it's got a 150 Yamaha scuppers, because it's got a self-draining deck like you'd want. 150 Yamaha, you've heard me rave. I can't say more about a 150 Yamaha than I've said, other than buy one. That's it. Just go and buy one. Talk to someone that's got one. Scuppers, Garmin, GPS, hydraulic steering, the transducer there. Now, let's have a look. Look at this ladder. This ladder's awesome, isn't it? Dive style ladder. Very high quality, very easy to get into. Great. Let's have a look at this, because this is what he's done. Look at this, Dan. Another one of those transom doors, just solid. That's quality, easy to get in, drag a fish through, battery isolation switch, stainless steel rod holders, beautiful 12-inch Garmin, 6YC gauge. Look at this switch panel here. This, you know, this is yellowfin, it's quality. See that sticker there? That's the Brisbane Yamaha sticker. You take that off, no warranty. Only joking. Now, stereo, more panel, more switches down here. What in hell has he got down here? Everything, you have nav lights, bait pumps, rear deck, you know, 12 volt sockets. You got your trim tabs, you got storage down here. You know, we've got storage, we've got this back-to-back seat, and we've got a great big esky. You know, because he catches a lot of fish, this bloke. He can fish, don't worry about that. He goes everywhere. And that's why he goes. Sometimes I think he must be some sort of illegal fisher, but he's not. Don't look at that. I'm not saying that he's done, but this is awesome. Big fish kill box, you know, batches in the back. Nice, nice bait board. You can see it's been used, but it's not scratching up. He's got some knives here. Live bait tank. Big enough for all your slimies. You get all your mullet in there. You could almost get a tuna. Good side decks, you know, that you can put your feet under, lean up. That's quite ergonomic if you're really into something big, trying to ground him up. You got some Sambo out there giving you a hard time. And I like this, you know. You could sit here driving. Well, I'd sit on this side because I'm the throttle man. Dan would be sitting over here. We can hold on as we go. We can look at the gauges. We can both work the sounder. Rod storage over here, this is nice. You got the fuel tank. Now, Dan, put all the specs up. Because for beams and widths and stuff, put the specs up and have a look. Because every time I do it, people complain. Now, you got stereos, fuel. Obviously, you got the fuel filler on the outside. You got this wonderful bit of storage. You know, I'd fill that with ice. Could do anything, guys. Safety gear, tackle, gaffs, clubs, beating stuff up, you know. Up here, nice big deck, huge big anchor well, and then we've got a bit of rubber in there. You can see that, just so it doesn't clang around as you're going out. you can see this nice console and it folds down so you can storage, rod storage on the side. This is a beautiful boat, isn't it? You know, good area for fishing. And it's a good size boat, 6.5 meters. You go anywhere in this. He does a lot up in north, lot in, lot out. To tell the truth, if he has fisher on, if he has this billfish out in the Gold Coast, if he has something's going up in the ribbons, off he goes with this thing. You know, and look at the storage. Look how solid this is. You know, you get a wave, it all just washes out, scuppers. And these, then you've got these huge storage. Oh, you're a bloody joke. Joey again. Come on, Joey, hurry up. You meant to clean it, not snooze in there. Who else is in there, you know? If I find one of the detailers get pregnant, Joey. Look in there. Now have a look at this. Look at this, Dan. Seriously, that's the sort of storage that you really need. Now what we did is we took his crab pots out of here. He had buckets, he had crab pots. He had all that stuff that you can't fit in your boat. All in here. You could get a serious esky in here too if you wanted to. We could plumb it out for you.